we are back. We've come to Panda Express on Citywalk for dinner. We didn't have anything at the hotel in the end. We just sat by the pool for ages. Let's have a look at this. So what did this come to? Just a shade over $20?
$20.93
for the two meals. And they're absolutely massive. So you get two entrees and a side in each one. I had teriyaki chicken and Beijing beef and fried rice. Kim had chow mein.
Wok fried shrimp. And honey sesame chicken.
Yeah, it's huge. Such good value for money here. And then some free ice water as well. We say it's good value for money. Say it's just over $20 for both of these massive meals. Look how much meat is in here. Really good value for money. And it tastes so good as well. Mm. We sat out on the balcony just outside Panda Express and Moe's in Citywalk. We can people watch, which is one of my favourite activities. Nosy in, seeing where everyone's going.
Around everyone, gather round. We represent the Hogwarts School Choir, and we're here to share some music with you. Because music is, as Professor Dumbledore has said, a magic beyond all we do here. So let's start with one of my personal favourites, shall we?
You think that?
I loved it.
You love that? That's been on your list since we got here, hasn't it?
So, if, so
right, so we left Panda Express, we bombed it over to Islands because we saw that the Frog Choir was on at 7 and we just made it in time, didn't we?
It was when they played the Hogwarts band.
Yeah. Yeah, because it makes us laugh, doesn't it? My boy! Dum, da-da-dum, dum. Yeah, it's brilliant. My boy! It was good, yeah. Considering how bad, like, the Sing It show is in Universal, that, like, a cappella thing was actually really good.
That's really, yeah.
I bet we'll be able to smash this out tomorrow as well, you know. As soon as it opens, I bet we want to do that again. We're just coming up with a plan for tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning's checkout day, obviously. So we're going to come in for early entry, aren't we? Do Velocicoaster while everyone's on Hagrid's. Jurassic Park River Adventure again. One of the favourites. And I reckon we'll be able to walk on this. If we want to do Kong again. As long as they've not got that scare actor in the queue. No, thank you. I don't even know if they still have him in there anymore.
Maybe not.
Nah. Maybe they deemed him too scary. I would vote he was too scary. There's one ride we never got on. I completely forgot about it. Today would have been a good day for it earlier on, you know what I mean? But I completely, like, before we went back to the pool. But we were having such a good time in Universal with the Blues Brothers and things. I completely forgot about it. So only when we got back to the room before going to the pool, and you can see it from our hotel room, I was like, oh, you know what, that would have been good. Next time. I'm not doing it tomorrow, I travel home day. I think you get so wet on that, I'd never dry off. I can't be honest with you, I don't really get this area. The comic strip area. What's it called? Toon Lagoon? Yeah, I kind of don't get it. Like, I recognise a few of the comic characters, but I don't know. It's just a walkthrough, isn't it? Other than the wet rides. Yeah, the wet rides. I like the rides because of the rides. I don't really understand much of the theming, especially the log flume one. Everyone knows Popeye, obviously, for the barges, but the log flume one, I ain't got a clue what's going on. Was Rocky and Bullwinkle part of all this? I don't know. I remember Rocky and Bullwinkle. Who knows? Not me, that's for sure.
We're good to see that.
What, that? Yeah, do you know what? I've no idea what that was ever used for. There's a giant auditorium in the back of Islands here, just between Toon Lagoon and Marvel Superhero Island.
considering we've done quite a lot of the shows this trip, it would be nice to have a bit more, I think.
Yeah, imagine if they did like stunt show or something in there, or yeah, that'd been cool. It's just sat there empty. I've never known them to do anything in there. I must have done once. I do really like it down here. I think it's really cool. Like, I love that it's the comics, like based on the comics, you know what I mean, rather than anything else, movies or whatever. There's a clear distinction between the Disney stuff and this. It's really cool. Hulk feels like a bit like the granddad of the park, doesn't he? Do you know what I mean? Look, I will never say that to his face though.
That was like the big poster for you.
That's what, I never came as a kid. I didn't come until 2014 for the first time, but when I ever used to see like the holiday brochures or whatever, it was always Hulk and Spider-Man on the front. Or on the websites, it was always the Hulk coaster. It always looked amazing. We're sat in as well. The one edge that Hulk has over Velocicoaster onboard audio. Imagine if Velocicoaster had like the speakers in your ears like Hulk has. It'd just be just that little bit extra. It'd be awesome. I think tonight has been a prime example of why this holiday's been so good. Because what have we done? We left the hotel, had some Panda Express, bombed it over and watched the frog choir, and then just took a stroll around islands. Not even ridden on anything. Because we've had the extra time, there's been no pressure, it's just been brilliant.
I would 100% recommend a Universal vacation.
Yeah.
I love just walking around.
Yeah, just taking it all in. It's this area that I've really like appreciated since we've been here. Port of Entry. I don't think I've ever stopped to like proper look at it. I've got the music like ingrained in my head now. It's just awesome. Probably through the arches for probably the last time on this trip, you reckon? Probably. It's been a really good day. So the plan tonight is the, what's it even called? Cinematic Spectacular? What it's called? At 9 o'clock, so we've got like an hour and a half. Oh no, sorry, we've got about an hour. Got about an hour. And we keep meaning to see it all trip, and it got washed out a couple of times because of the rain. So tonight, a final night, tonight's the night. I feel like this is the first proper Floridian evening we've had, do you know what I mean? I was just saying yesterday we haven't had a nice sunset yet, but tonight is the one. So the wait times are relatively low. We haven't got an awful lot of time before the cinematic celebration that we really want to watch. But one of our favourites, Transformers, is only a 10-minute wait. So we're going to do Transformers, and then possibly Jimmy Fallon afterwards if it's still on 5-minute wait. Which, 9 times out of 10 it is. But we love it. And then I reckon that'll be that. It'll be that time for the show. We just love Transformers. This ride is awesome. No idea what's going on. Don't know what an AllSpark is. But we love it. 10 minutes, let's do it.
Relinquish what remains of the AllSpark, or suffer the wrath of Megatron.
There's Optimus Prime, just got off Transformers. I love Transformers. It's so good, it's so impressive. But it is proper immersive, isn't it?
Yeah.
But yeah, the ride is just so good. If that ride was in the UK, that'd have like 2-hour waits every day, do you know what I mean? It's here, we just walked on it, it's bonkers. And now we've done Spider-Man recently as well, we can confidently say
Transformers is, yeah,
miles ahead. Yeah, I do love Spider-Man, but Transformers is just next level. Rip Ride Rocket in the background. We're going to miss seeing them lights every night. So a lot of the time on this trip in the evening, it's been private events, so the park's been shut quite early, at least one of them. So Rip Ride Rocket, we've been back at the hotel room, you can see the lights from our room. You just see it going round all night, don't we? We're not allowed to play on it, but we can see it going around from a distance. It has been really good, yeah. Considering it's just a standard cheapo, well, relatively cheap room. Cheapest room they had. And we got lucky, didn't we?
Yeah.
Bit of car park, but then you can see Citywalk, you can see both parks.
That's better, yeah, I like seeing the
It's
park.
Awesome. Hey man, how you doing? Something like that. Let's get a selfie. Thank you very much.
Alright.
See ya. Not gonna lie, we are very gutted that the mummy is closed. We knew it would be, that's why we made sure to ride it when we was here in November. But it is so good. Definitely sorely missed this trip. Although they have got this little shop just here, handed up a sign by this guy next to the mummy. This is very cool, very spooky. Horror Nights vibes. A bit like the shop that is in Islands now. The tiki sort of Halloween shop. It's got a lot of classic monsters things. All the little lunch boxes, they're cool. Socks. Just love the displays, look at him. What have we got around here? Invisible Man. Bride of Frankenstein, Frankenstein's monster. I do like all the action figures they've got of all the characters. These are really cool. And the lounge floor we've seen everywhere. We've got Zoltar, can wish to be big. I don't want to be any bigger. I'm done with being big, thank you. Excellent find, wife, this shot. Were you spotted? We can't sink any more money on a grabber machine, surely, surely. She's away.
No, we didn't see a lot of this part.
So we're just making our way around to the viewing area to watch the cinematic spectacular. Back in Springfield again, can't stay away. But how good does it look at night time? Again, this crappy camera is just doing no favours, is it? But I promise you, it looks really cool. We are slightly biased because we are big Simpsons fans, like big Simpsons fans. But this place is just awesome. Right, we're just settling in now. We've got our spot. You right down there? We've got our spot ready for the cinematic celebration. Really looking forward to this. What a great way to end the trip. Well, final night anyway.
We gather to relive these incredible moments in our cinematic celebration.
marshmallow who's gonna have to follow that.
What?
We are the marshmallows. Oh, stall until I can come up with something better.
Looks nice at night time, doesn't it? I think the Hollywood section looks nicest at night time. All the lights. Just down there where we've just come from. Oh no, tell a lie, you're right. Springfield is the best one at night time. Christmas time, it was the New York area, weren't it?
Yeah, definitely.
When we was here in November. We probably will not be back in here tomorrow, so that is it for Universal Studios. It's been a blast. Had a great time. Easily the best time we've ever, we've ever had in this park. Easily. Right, we're gonna get through the crowds, get on our bus back to Cabana Bay, and we'll catch up when we get home. Finally back in the room. That cinematic celebration was really, really good.
Really, really good.
Just like when we watched Harmonious on the last trip series, Epcot. I wish we had watched this earlier on in the trip. Just Harmonious was the same. We watched it on, like, the, I think it was the one from last night. We had no more time to watch it again. This is the same. I wish we had more time now to watch that again, because it was really, really good. It was funny how, like I was just saying, the Fast and Furious section on that show was like better than the actual ride. Like, it was really, really cool, and the trolls bit was actually really good.
The trolls bit was my favorite.
Yeah, I think the trolls bit was my favorite too, surprisingly. But it was all really, really good, and it was quite nice not being like crushed in with everyone like you have at Disney. Enough people watched it, but not like loads and loads of people. There was loads of space, and it's just really, really good. So if you are at Universal and this is on, don't sleep on it. Make sure you go and watch it.
Definitely watch it, yeah.
Definitely watch it. Watch it early on in your trip so you don't make the mistake we did and run out of time so you can't watch it again. But yeah, that is the end of our final day. It's been a bit of everything, just like every other day. Both parks, fair few rides, a couple of shows. You saw you for a choir. Yeah, that's been on your list since we got here. Yeah, and some pool time. The pool time has been crucial on this trip.
Oh, it's been great.
Yeah, we've been, that was one of the things, the main draw of just doing Universal was having time for the pool.
Yeah, and enjoying the hotel.
Yes, and we have very much so. So yeah, now we are gonna, I suppose we better do some packing. Do a bit of packing, and then tomorrow we check out. So tomorrow we plan on doing early entry one more time. We don't fly until the evening. I think it's like 10 to 9 or something. So yeah, we're going to do early entry one more time. We have to ride Velocicoaster one more time. So we're going to do Velocicoaster, and then as soon as River Adventure opens, you want to do that, and Jurassic Park River Adventure, because that's one of our favourites. Do them, and then have a chill day around the hotel, I think. Maybe get some Uber Eats in.
Yeah, we don't want to leave the hotel.
No.
I don't think so.
I don't think so. Yeah. Just pop over to the parks for the morning and come back and check out and chill by the pool with some Uber Eats. Mm-hmm. That sounds like a plan. And then get an Uber over to the airport and away we go. We're flying direct home tomorrow, straight home with BA. So it should be pretty simple. So yeah, that's it. That's the end of our final day. Bit sad, but it's been a great trip. And yeah, off we go home tomorrow. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And yeah, we'll see you for travel home day tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.